Malwari book, 8th. So I request every one of you to keep it ready. Take out the chapter 1, the new house, page number 7. We have read about Bruno moving home and feeling that his sister is not fun to play with. Now let us read about another kind of relationship between a brother and sister. Yes, in the reader, in course book, we have read the about the Bruno who is moving and feeling that his sister is not fun to play. Now there is one story is there. It will show the relationship between a brother and a sister. Let's see. Read the poem given below and answer the questions that follow. So children, again, there is a comprehension that you have to do. He has given the poem. It has given the poem and you have to write down the answers in the. Harry pushed her. He pushed her around. He pushed his sister before school and after school. Harry pushed her sister around before school and after school. On weekends, he pushed his sister. He had no friends. Can you understand why it was saying he pushed her? Because this shows that the girl, that his sister, Harry's sister, is having some physical problem. Are you able to see in the picture? That girl is sitting on the chair. Wheelchair. So children, it shows that she is physically challenged girl. He pushed her sister. He had no friends. He pushed her school holidays and Christmas time. The children always sang. They made up rhyme. Harry push her now. Harry push the crazy cow. Harry push her without strain. Those no sunshine, wind and rain. So the children, there were no friends, only Harry was always helping her sister. He was taking care of his sister. And so all the time, every time, Harry used to take care of his beloved sister. And the children, they used to sing the song that Harry push her, Harry push her now. Harry push the crazy cow, Harry push her without strain. Though snow, sunshine, wind and rain. She smiled strangely. His sister used to smile when she heard this song from the children. And never said a word. He pushed for years. It was so abused. That means actually that his sister is physically challenged. That's why Harry used to take care of him by pushing the wheelchair. Harry was 12. His sister was 23. My goodness. Harry never had a childhood like me. Harry pushed her without a care. He pushed his sister in the wheelchair. Yes, just now I told her. She used to say, that his brother doesn't enjoy the childhood because all the time he used to take care of his sister who was 23 years old. So children, this is my humble request to you also. Relationship between a brother and a sister is very precious and valuable in this world. We have to be caring. We have to take care of our brothers or sisters. We have to keep a bond of love and caring between us. Now Harry, this was the poem written by Peter Habit Jones. Now children, here are some lines that tell Harry's character from this list. Circle the adjectives that you would see to describe Harry. Harry pusher without strain, though snow, sunshine and rain. These are the two lines. Now from these you have to describe, you have to underline those words which shows that how Harry is. What is adjective? Adjective is a describing word. Harry is a self-centered? No. Harry is strong, sincere, lovable? Yes. He is compassionate, hardworking, responsible, indifferent. So, you have to answer this in this way. Even though childhood was difficult for Harry, he never complained about but took it in step to help his sister. He was a very good boy with a kind and helpful heart. This shows that Harry is a very, Harry is having a good character. Now you have to list three ways in which Harry's life was different from that of other children. Yes, the three ways in which Harry's life was different from that of other are, Harry did not get to play like all the other children and he had no friends. He had to physically work hard to push his sister who was much older than him. He did not get to celebrate special occasions like others. They had to listen to the taunt by others. What is your opinion of other children mentioned in the poem? Give evidence from the poem to support your opinion. Yes. Children, I am going to send you all the answers from the key. Copy down that answers from the key and complete your workbook with pencil. Write the meaning of the following word. Rhyme, strain, absurd. Rhyme means sound between two words of the ending of words, especially when these are used at the end lines of the poetry. Strain, make unusually great effort. Absurd, unreasonable, illogical, ridiculous. Now, make sentences of your own with the words, following words. Strangely, childhood, care. In more than 60 words, write the summary of the poem. Give a suitable title for this poem. So, this was the part A comprehension. Now, it's time for grammar. Here, underline the noun in each sentence and say whether they are proper common material or abstract noun. Yes, the sentences are here. You have to underline the abstract noun or what the noun it is. You have to underline and you have to write what kind of noun it is in the blank. Sentence mein se aapko wo jo bhi word noun lag raha hai, pehle hum usko underline karenge aur phir wo kis category ka noun hai usko hum side mein likhenge. Charity begins at home. Here, charity is a noun and home is a noun. Charity is abstract, whereas home is common. Fortune favors the bold. Fortune is an abstract noun. Indira, who wore shoes made of blue, suit. Yes, Indira, proper, shoes, common, suit, material. The children went to the zoo to see the white tiger. Children, common. Zoo, common. Tiger, common. Cricket balls are made up of cork covered by leather. Cricket, common. Balls, common. Cork material, leather material. The girls were taught to respect loyalty and integrity. Yes, girls, common. Loyalty, abstract. Integrity, abstract. At the museum, Jane saw many figurines made of brass. Museum common, Jane proper, figurines common, brass material. Our car broke soon after we crossed the post office. Car common, post office common. On Sundays, the boys play football at Chilla Sports Complex. Sundays proper, boys common, football common, Chilla Sports Complex proper. All the students in the school appreciate Mrs. Mehta's generosity. Students common, Mrs. Mehta proper, generosity abstract. Yes, children, I am going to send you the keys. Write down it with pencil in your workbook. Next, fill in the blanks with appropriate collective nouns from the box. The armory contained an ornate dash of arrows. Yes, the armory contained, that is quiver. Q-U-I-V-E-R. quiver. The crew was excited to see the dash of islands. Yes, archipelago. He kept a dash of chickens in the farm. Brood. Audrey signed the dash of papers placed before. Chef. A dash of performance will be present at the annual day celebration. Troop. Gerald Darley had a curious dash of animals in the zoo. Mina Gire. Rewrite the sentences changing gender of the highlighted nouns. The Tsar's tiara was found by the shepherdess. Now, what is the opposite gender of shepherdess? That is shepherd. So, you have to write the Tsarian's tiara was found by the shepherd. The gentlemen of the village went to the duke. The ladies of the village went to welcome the duchess. The landlord lives on the floor above mine. The landlady lives on the floor above mine. After many days of wandering, Jacob met a group of traveling monk. After many days of wandering, Jacob met a group of traveling nuns. Everyone was surprised when the heiress donated her estate to the school. Everyone was surprised when the heir donated his estate to the school. So children, once again, Tsar, Tsarian, shepherd is shepherd. Gentlemen, ladies, duke, duchess, landlord, landlady, nun, monks, nuns, heiress, heir. Identify if the highlighted words are countable or uncountable. Yes. My friend gave me a green bag of my birthday. So, bag is countable. A few years ago, we lived in a city by the sea. Years, countable. I like my coffee with a dollop of cream on top. Cream, uncountable. He carried the bucket of water carefully up the stairs. Water, uncountable. We heard a strange piece of news this morning. Uncountable. Now children, your homework is that you have to write the articles given in the paragraph. Insert a cross if article is not needed. And as well as when you turn the page, when you turn the page, yes, this is the page of article. And next page, you have to write about the, write well, a turncoat, yes. A turncoat is a person who leaves in a party to cause, to join opposing one. Be a turncoat and write two constructing paragraph on any one of the topic. There are three topics, one you have to write. The topics are we too dependent on technology? Yes, we have. Is competition good? Sometimes. Students should have to wear uniforms? Yes. So this you have to write in your books. I am showing you once again. Have a look. You have to write these. These are the three topics given. Please, children, do it. This is your homework. I hope you have understood. You are going to complete all the answers in very neatly manner. And children, try to recapitulate the things and try to learn the things. Till wait for your next class. Till then, bye-bye. Good day. Take care.